Say a little more.
Try a little more.
Testing again, one more time. They asked the sound man why he always said 1, 2, 1, 2, and he said, because if I say 1, 2, 3, 4, the band starts playing. On WBGO, they have an ad that, wow, what is jazz? And they get very pompous about it, you know. It's really hard for me to say what it is, you know. It's a whole world and a wonderful game for the musicians to play. Evidently, it's interesting enough for the general public to listen to and find something interesting in it, but the thing that we love about it is that we can play this game. We know how to do this. Isn't this wonderful, you know?
So, Bill, I'm curious who one of your biggest musical influences was.
Oh, on the bass, gee. You know, I was a record collector when I was a teenager, and the bass players that I remember from those records that I bought were Jimmy Blanton, when he was with Ellington.
I know you did a lot of gigs during your career, Bill, so I'm curious if you could go back and do one. I'm sure there's a few that stand out, but what would be that one gig you'd like to go back?
I would think playing at the Half Note with Bob Brookmeyer and Clark Terry's quintet. That was such a hot band. Roger Calloway was the piano player and Dave Bailey was the drummer. The whole ambiance in that club was so positive, you know. They turned all the musicians into family. For me, it's swing. It makes you want to move in a happy way, you know. It makes you want to dance. And if we get that going, I'm happy with that band. You know?
So Bill, all of us have read from cover to cover your wonderful Jazz Anecdotes book. And I know that you were there for a lot of those moments and then so many more were shared with you. But I'm curious if there's a standout story or two or three from that book.
Some of the Joe Venuti stories. He was a prankster when he was with Paul Whiteman's band. He brought in a little sack of sand every day and tucked it into the F-hole of the bass. And it was getting heavier and heavier, and the guy's saying, gee, I'm really getting old, you know, I can't carry this thing anymore. In my day, when the big bands were popular, a jukebox in the local drugstore or diner might have 24 tunes, I would say 10 of which I was interested in hearing. And now you go, if you can find a jukebox now, it'll be 1,000 choices and I don't want to hear any of them. You know?
What do you see yourself doing in the next phase of your life?
Answering the phone and saying yes.
Young, absolutely young. 96-year-old Bill Crow.
Well, the audience is usually my friends, so, you know, even if I've just met them, they've come because they like something about what I'm about to do. Whatever the music is, even if it's not jazz, I love playing music. It's just wonderful to hear that stuff come out of the instruments, you know.